Those who anger him really have no good end. Explosions at gas stations at the slightest disagreement. If you still resist, he'll blow up your building. Jason is now a beekeeper. He used to be an agent for a secret organization. That day, the landlord asked for his help to clear a wasp nest in the warehouse. Jason applied his expertise and swiftly finished the clearing task. The landlord invited Jason to dinner as an appreciation because the landlord usually took good care of Jason, so Jason gladly accepted. When the landlord returned to work at home, a message suddenly popped up on his computer. The message indicated a computer glitch and provided a phone number to call for a solution. The landlord, not knowing much about computers, immediately called as instructed. Unexpectedly, this turned out to be a scam company's trap. The scammer pretended to be a computer repair expert and asked the landlord to follow his directions to operate the computer, otherwise all data would be lost. The landlord believed it to be true and followed the scammer's instructions step by step. He entered his password under the scammer's guidance. As a result, the computer screen went black immediately, and all the money in the account was transferred out. The landlord's grandmother then realized she had been scammed. Jason, holding a bottle of his home-brewed honey, arrived at the landlord's house as agreed. However, when he knocked at the door, there was no response. Out of urgency, Jason decided to enter to check the situation. Upon entering, he found that the landlord had committed suicide. Police officer Amy arrived home. Seeing the scene before her, she immediately drew her gun on Jason and notified the police. The police quickly arrived at the scene and conducted a preliminary investigation. Their conclusion was the landlord's grandmother had committed suicide. Subsequently, the police took Jason to the station for further questioning. That evening, Amy, while checking her mother's computer, found that not a penny was left in her mother's account. The next day, Amy found Jason and apologized to him for the misunderstanding. During their conversation, Amy revealed the tragic truth behind her mother's suicide. Her mother, having been deceived, had chosen to end her life in despair. After hearing this, Jason decided to avenge the landlord in his own way. He returned to the beekeeping factory and called a former colleague, asking for her help to track down the scammer who called the landlord yesterday. With his colleague's assistance, Jason quickly tracked down the address of the scam company. An angry Jason, with two canisters of gasoline, drove to the scam group. A security guard at the door tried to stop him. With one punch each, Jason easily knocked them to the ground and entered the group's interior. He made the scammers say with him,
"I will never steal from the weak, the vulnerable again."
But nobody paid attention to him. Jason had to teach them a lesson. Just then, the person in charge came with guards and had the guards teach Jason a lesson. These guys were no match for Jason. He knocked them all over within moments. Jason didn't trouble the person in charge. Instead, he took the canisters and made an explosive device. Then he left the building. With a loud bang, the building was blown to ruins. The person in charge immediately contacted the mastermind, reporting the bombing. The boss ordered him to find this person and kill him. The person in charge, with his men, found Jason's residence and fired shots at his beekeeping box. Jason, hearing the gunshots, entered the warehouse and turned on all the machinery to create noise. As these men entered the warehouse, Jason prepared to take them down one by one. He first strangled a bald guy with a chain, then knocked another person's neck with the butt of his gun, and finally dealt with the last thug. The person in charge, seeing all the thugs killed, fled in fear. The fleeing person in charge called the boss. But how could Jason let him go? Jason, who caught up, dragged him out of the car, tied him with a rope, determined to give him a taste of flying.
"Because you don't burn me, don't—"
Jason picked up the phone, still connected, and told the mastermind he would find him. As it turns out, this mastermind was the current president's son. Out of fear of being chased down, he found the former director of the secret agency, hoping he could help resolve the Jason problem. Upon finding out that it was Jason he had offended, The former director also worried and told him that Jason was once affiliated with the secret agency, though now retired. You shouldn't have provoked him. The former director, unwilling to help under the pressure of the president and vested interests, still contacted the secret agency, asking them to send someone to deal with Jason. Jason, at the gas station, unaware he was being watched by agents, was about to drive off when a car slammed into his. A pink-dressed woman got out of the car, but by the time she came to the front of the car, Jason had disappeared. She then encountered the police rushing to the scene and, without a word, directly opened fire. Jason took the opportunity to knock down her gun and strangled her neck with the fuel hose hitting the fuel tank. The woman, unable to beat Jason, used a Gatling gun from the rear of her vehicle and crazily fired at the gas station. Still, she could not escape being subdued by Jason. At the same time, the former director received a call from the agency, saying they had analyzed the situation and decided to remain neutral. On the other hand, the police were also searching for Jason for blowing up the scam organization's building and gas station. Jason arrived at the residence of the pink-dressed woman and, through her computer, successfully located another scam company address of the mastermind. By now, the police already had grasp of Jason's next plan and had deployed a large police force at the scam company site. It was thought that with so many forces at the scene, Jason wouldn't appear. But Jason doesn't play by the rules. He walked up to the guards in charge of the site and, with the speed of lightning, took down the guards at the door. After dealing with the front guards, Jason went to the company interior where guards were on watch. The guards opened fire on Jason. Jason climbed to the ceiling of the hallway. While the guards were unaware, he hoisted them up and knocked down another guard. Jason set up a simple trap in the hallway and quickly climbed to the top of the elevator. He blew the elevator's cables and easily dealt with the guards that were chasing him. Jason found the person in charge here, gave him a good beating, and then asked who the mastermind was. The person in charge confessed it was the president's son. Just then, Amy arrived. Jason said that this man bears the primary responsibility for your mother's death. Amy stressed that we have laws and we must trust in the law, but Jason countered by saying that they would render the law ineffective. After speaking, Jason turned and left. The police also arrested the person in charge there. Meanwhile, the former director, receiving the news, advised the mastermind to hide at his mother's place. Otherwise, it would be difficult to ensure his safety. Reluctantly, he called his mother to say he would visit her. The next day, the mastermind took refuge at his mother's presidential residence. The former director had also specially hired a private bodyguard for him, Blonde Kid. The presidential residence was indeed heavily guarded. At this time, Jason arrived at the drain and entered smoothly. He went to the well and crawled under a car, knocking out the guard, inspecting the underside of the car. Successfully blending into the presidential residence, he installed explosives under a vehicle. After finishing this, Jason changed clothes and calmly blended into the party. Amy noticed Jason then. The guards quickly surrounded Jason. Jason managed to get the bomb remote in his hand, unnoticed by the guards. Then he detonated the bomb, making his way into the presidential residence amidst the chaos. Inside, Jason encountered guards and engaged in close combat. Jason blocked by Blonde Kid in front of the president's door. They engaged in fierce hand-to-hand combat, exchanging punches and kicks. Then Blonde Kid stabbed a dagger into Jason's abdomen. Jason struggled, kicking Blonde Kid on his prosthetic leg. Eventually, Blonde Kid was defeated by Jason. Jason found the mastermind. Unexpectedly, he held his own mother hostage. Amy also arrived, urging Jason to surrender. Jason resolved the mastermind and jumped out the window to escape. Amy, pointing a gun at Jason, eventually couldn't bring herself to shoot. Jason ran to the beach, took out the diving suit he had prepared earlier, and successfully escaped. The film ends here. See you next episode.